Patricia is an associate professor of material science and technology at the Department of Civil and Industrial Engineering here in Pisa, the University of Pisa. Polymer blends and composite preparation, modulation of the properties and connection with sources, end of life and recycling aspects are the main focus of her research activity. So thank you, and please, Beatrice, the floor is yours.
Thank you, Alfonso, and I would like to speak especially of the results obtained in the Cofanco project, so I will try to skip the introductory part as much as possible. And you know that Ecofanco project is aimed at producing personal care, disposable products and multi-layer packages. And in our case, we have made a preliminary study to understand what methodologies and materials can be used for coating cellulose and bioplastics for these applications. And so these results were also published at the beginning of the project. We have seen that many of the proposed materials are certainly based on chitin and chitosan. And this was also okay for us because we have yet experience on that. So we thought that a project that could allow us to go on with these researches could be very good. And in fact, as University of Pisa and the NSTM, we have developed a platform of chitin nanofibers-based coatings for cellulose, for bioplastic, and we have proposed water-based, so liquid coatings, but also hot melt coatings, so solid coatings, and this is pretty innovative. We know that chitin and cellulose are present in structural materials, and chitin is also very abundant, and we know that the most abundant source is shrimps based. Many of us have spoken about this source that is very abundant, especially in Asia, but also, for example, in Argentina, we have heard. And we know also that there are different kinds of chitin. There is alpha chitin that is more resistant, that is present, it is more diffused, present in insects, in crustaceans, but also in fungi, and beta chitin that is less frequent. Obviously, we have to consider that, for example, in the exoskeleton of crustaceans, chitin is present as nanofibrils because poly N-acetyl glucosamide is assembled in these nanofibrils that are embedded into a matrix. So it is necessary to extract from shrimp shells, the chitin by the mineralization, the proteinization, to obtain chitin, which is a very tough material made by microfibers, and it is necessary to transform it into chitosan by the acetylation or by a mildly acetylation in chitin nanofibrils. So we had a collaboration with Pierfrancesco Morganti that had developed a methodology in the past to produce chitin nanofibrils. In this case, these solid nanofibrils are positively charged on the surface, and for this reason, they can show antimicrobial properties similarly to chitosan, but we needed to explore it better. So we started our work considering that chitin nanofibrils are generated from this milder deacetylation, and the acetylation degree, for example, was an important parameter to consider. And we had to insert these chitin nanofibrils into bioplastics to produce nanocomposites that could be good for some requirements of the packaging industry. In fact, we should develop materials for coffee capsules and for films in the framework of NanoKetoPack project, where also Professor Morganti was participating and also coordinating this project. Successively, we have also considered to disperse chitin nanofibrils into blends of PLA for another European project, PolyBioSkin, for applications that are not that were not in the packaging field, but in the sanitary field. So, what was the main understanding we had? That we needed to disperse at a nanometric level these nanofibrils into bioplastics. So if we dried the suspension produced by Pier Francesco Morganti, we obtained a solid that could not be dispersed. It was important to produce a pre-dispersion material that could be dispersed by extrusion into our bioplastics. Thanks to this methodology, we could obtain bio-nanocomposites. And so we have published all this data in different papers and that you can find. And we have also considered the properties of chitin nanofibrils and nanolignin complexes that can be used to modify the surfaces. Looking at the application of these materials as coating, we started to understand that it is important to use them for example, packaging, collaborating with Lucenze in a project where we applied these chitin nanofibrils onto recycled and virgin paperboard. Here you can see some scanning electron micrograph related to the presence of the coating onto this board, and we demonstrated that this treated board showed antimicrobial properties and that, for example, fresh pasta, for fresh pasta we obtained an increase of shelf life. And the properties were similar for chitosan and chitin nanofibrils. So this showed to us that chitin nanofibrils could be as efficient as chitosan. So we went on in Ecofanco to apply these findings into applications for personal care. So we consider tissues that are packed in boxes. And so we applied again our chitin nanofibrils, this time produced by Cellabor, which produced these chitin nanofibrils with an alternative methodology based also on mechanical on a mechanical step that helped in producing chitin nanofibrils. And the results that we obtained were similar to our previous study. And then we applied also these chitin nanofibrils onto tissues. So you can see the difference in between the paper tissue and the treated paper. We can also see a magnification that can show us the nanostructure given by the chitin nanofibrils. Interestingly, we have treated the tissue also with polyphenols extracted by University of Alicante to see if this additive could be also good for personal care application. We performed mechanical tests onto these tissues, puncture resistant test, but also tensile test, and tearing test and impact test, that demonstrated that the mechanical properties were only slightly modified by the coating, and so these applications in the personal care and packaging sector were possible. So we also considered chitin from mushrooms, and this can be a good alternative, even though the chitin is less present in mushrooms than in shrimps. This can be interesting because generally chitin is complex to beta-glucans in fungi. So this can be a different source also to compare the results. And in fact, we applied both shrimp-based chitin nanofibrils and fungi-based nanofibrils onto bioplastics. And it was possible to see some differences. Regarding the concentration of the chitin nanofibrils, we observed that the adhesion to the bioplastics was not very good. So we adopted the methodology of using a product of the of Condensa Chimica, which is a partner of Ecofanco, to increase the adhesion of these shrimps-based chitin nanofibrils onto bioplastics. Here I reported only the results related to one bioplastic, but we have tested several bioplastic films produced by the three companies of the project. And then we also have tried with fungi, and we observed that in this case the application could avoid the use of the oligomeric lactic acid from Condensa Chimica. So fungi are more showed a higher adhesion to bioplastic, and this was very curious. Another interesting result was that if we used the chitin nanofibrils alone onto bioplastics, we could not obtain antimicrobial properties. And also if we used oligomeric lactic acid alone, but combined together, yes. So probably the predispersion of the chitin nanofibrils into this compatibilizer for the surface treatment enhance these properties. So the results are interesting and not easy to be interpreted, but we think that probably the fungi-based chitin nanofibrils are less polar, probably because of the presence of beta-glucans that are not deacetylated because they cannot. This can be an interpretation, but we should also support it with other data. These coatings were applied by flexography and with a very good homogeneity by the BioMe company that participated to the project. And then we developed also hot melt coatings because we can have some advantages in the industrial development and use of these coatings. So in this case, collaborating with the consortium, we selected additives and matrix and also chitosan and chitin. We developed so two hot melts that were studied in laboratory phase, and they were affecting in making both bioplastic and cellulosic substrates slightly antimicrobial. But interestingly, this production was scaled up by Planet Bioplastics, which is a company of the spin-off company of the University of Pisa. And so this is an interesting finding, and we could produce granules up to a semi-industrial level, thanks to the project. They were applied also onto paper by Organic Chimia, which is a company of the Ecofanco project, and they were validated industrially. So this last result were also extremely innovative. So we think that they are very good findings. Regarding the conclusion, it is important to find chitin nanofibrils and chitin in general from several sources. And in the last period, I collaborated with a professor in the south of Italy that is rearing, for example, Hermetia in Lucens, to consider chitin coming from insects too. And we developed so liquid coatings for application onto cellulosic board, onto bioplastics, and also solid versions of coating, because we can add many advantages and we can give more possibility for developing very alternative and very environmentally friendly products with functional properties. Thank you.
Thank you, Beatrice, and all your team, because you have presented results of the Ecofanco project where most of the partners were involved. So I think this is a good summary of the project. So the floor is open for one question, please.
Good morning. My question is very simple, and it's not directly related to your exposition. This is very good at all, but it's a question discharged from the common sense of a common person. No? Why in the paper industry we are milling, we are pulping the cellulose to make fibers, microfibers, and boiled up paper. And in this research, you chose to destroy chemically with very difficult chemical operation the structure of original chitin that is very, very, as in origin, very good properties, and it is not the same choice for chitin as well as for wood fiber, no, to destroy to grinding, pulping the original structure to obtain directly mechanically.
So chitin nanofibrils are antimicrobials. I think this property is not typical of the chitin because it is an insoluble and inert material. So we needed to exploit the functional properties of chitin nanofibrils or of chitosan. For this reason, we are searching for some additives that could go on the surface. I think that chitin nanofibrils for surface treatment are very good because they are fibers, so they stay on the surface. They do not penetrate inside the paper, so they do not modify the porosity of the paper. No? So they increase a little bit the mechanical properties, but without modifying the general structure. So this is also a thing that we noticed. I take also the occasion, because I forgot to thank all the partners, because it was impossible to make this research without them and without their proactive and very good collaboration. And also to these two people that you know very well, Dr. Vito Gigante and Dr. Luca Panariello, that worked a lot onto this activities onto these coatings. So this is my final answer.
Thank you, Beatrice. Thank you very much for your presentation.